And you have Anthony Davis, which I was listening to today.
Yes.
And they're all very good, Paul Di Resta. You see, I mean, I think the racing drivers are much better than TV commentators. If you say so yourself. No, I think that the level is very high because these guys, we just mentioned, they're very complete athletes, that they know what it takes, and they are very good, they're very articulate. But,
yeah, absolutely. Let's move on a little bit to Formula One as a whole. 2017, brand new regulation shift, cars were great, faster. How do you feel that the season is progressing under the new regulations?
I think that we all should be very proud of the changes that have been implemented. I mean, the cars are quicker, faster. I was looking today at some more cameras, and for example, from Turn 9 in Barcelona, it's a very high speed, 6-gear, flat out. I mean, they were putting 5.1 Gs around the corner, and in last year they were only 3.7. I mean, that is a huge difference for a driver, especially for the neck, and also for the cornering speeds. I think the changes are good. We have two teams that can win races regularly, hopefully three, hopefully four, hopefully McLaren as well soon. So I'm very happy about the changes as a spectator that I can see, I can comment on. And that's what all Formula One needs. We just need competition.
Yeah, absolutely. And it hasn't quite, I mean, we're only what, five races in for this season. There was lots of noises being made about the lack of overtaking. From where I sit as a fan, I think some of the overtakes that have happened already this year have been pretty spectacular.
Yeah, no, I mean, okay, yeah, you could say that there's less number of overtaking, but I think that is mostly due to the fact that the tires have very little degradation, they're very hard. But tomorrow, when you go to the track, the fact that last corner is taken flat through the race, every lap, easily flat, and you can have the DRS 100 meters earlier, this will be a deciding factor because it will be much easier to overtake than last year. Last year, last corner was not easy flat when you were following the car, so you had to back off sometimes when you were on the dirt gear. So I think this can have an effect and can have a very interesting race tomorrow.
Yeah, absolutely. You mentioned the battle now between Ferrari and Mercedes. Very interesting. Other people taking those victories. How do you see that playing out over the remainder of the season?
Well, I think that they will fight until the end, and I think that the team that has the highest rate of development will win the race. Simple as that. New regulations, every race, people are bringing new aero packages. It's not like the old days that you had one in Barcelona, one in Silverstone, and one for the end of the year. Now it's all different, and that's about it. Whoever invents 0.1, 0.2 per race, an average, will win the championship.
You're not prepared to make any predictions this early on?
Well, I think Mercedes will win, to be honest, because they have proven to be the fastest with all the cars, with one of the teams that are inventing time, lap time, in a very imaginative way. I've been at Ferrari, and in my era when I was there, I mean, we were not very good on the development, so I don't know about them anymore, but it doesn't look like they will have the strength to keep up the power. If it is only a prediction, you know.
That could be very, very wrong.
Well, we'll see. There's still plenty of the season to play out. So we've mentioned cars, we've mentioned the new regulations. Let's talk about Formula One, kind of from a fan, spectator point of view. A pretty big weekend this weekend. We've got some fans, Team McLaren members, in the audience tonight. There are some really positive steps, aren't there, with regards to fan engagement. You've seen it this weekend. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, I mean, funny you said that. You know what I really liked today is when the quali was over, that the drivers went to the front of the grandstand and they were interviewed in front of the grandstand, and they were, I think this is what Formula One is, the direction that they're moving to is fantastic. It's bringing the drivers closer to the spectators, opening a bit the social networks, and making it more attractive. You know, it's all about that. And also, I think that driver is making the drivers again a bit more of a hero.
Okay.
You know, that's also very positive because that's what people want to see is drivers above machines, not machines above drivers. And it's what we have been in the past 20 years, or as long as I've been in Formula One, which is 20 years. we've seen that machines or the cars are more important than the drivers. I think if we equalize a bit that, it will help promote Formula One.
Okay, good. Let's stay away from Formula One for a little bit. Automotive, road cars. You haven't mentioned briefly. You joined our red friends in Italy. time as a development driver on their road car program. You spent, I think it was an evening 2 years ago with us and McLaren for the winter board of customers looking at the road cars. How do you see that part of the business, McLaren Automotive, and some of the products they brought to market recently? Just outstanding.
Well, all I can say is that it's been a while since I haven't driven one of those, so I'm just looking forward. No. I don't have too much contact with McLaren Automotive in the past since we met 1 year and a half ago. The products that are coming out are impressive, and I wish I had one.
Okay, well, maybe we can.
It's unbelievable how fast they are, how big they are, and how aggressive they look.
Okay, last up, just before we say goodbye, Pedro, can you give us your thoughts for tomorrow? Kind of play it out for us. Who do you think is going to win? What do you think the podium is going to look like at the end of the race? And most importantly, where do you think our boys will end up?
Difficult, huh?
Yeah.
You know, I mean, one thing that I love from Fernando today is that when he just came out of the car, he said, I'm just happy I'm starting from this, you know, from the clean side of the grid. If I know a good start, I could be in the fight in the front. Okay, that's being optimistic, yeah. But how good is that? How good is that? I hope that he makes a good start and just gets in the mess there in the top. And we see him for a few laps there, maybe then he has to start thinking about the points and a realistic finish. But why not a top 8 finish? Then, and on the front, I think Vettel will be winning tomorrow. Very good long runs, very good on the rear tires. He had a mistake today in the last sector. I think the Ferraris are stunningly fast on this type of tracks.
Okay, you heard it here first, ladies and gents. That's Pedro de la Rosa's prediction for tomorrow. It would be great, wouldn't it, if Fernando does stick up the inside tomorrow?
Just before, you know, you remember in 2013,
yeah, he went on the outside.
He came out of turn 2, he went out on the outside of turn 3, and he started.
Fifth to second.
I think it was Kimi who went to.
Lewis.
It was amazing. And then in 2010, I've been viewing video starts, and then it was 2011, where he was starting fourth and he made it the first corner. He's a good starter,
and then Valencia, 2012.
Of where the other people are, 3D dimension, that I haven't seen many drivers like that perception. So I guess that he will make a couple of places tomorrow.
Let's hope so. Ladies and gents, before we say goodbye, we're actually going to give away a prize now. Pedro, would you mind giving us a hand to do that? Okay, once again, this is a partnership with Logitech and Logitech Chief. So, Pedro, just tell me, we're going to grab.